aún tiene el apoyo de la comunidad hispana?
Well, first of all, Piolín, my presidency is not over. I've got another 5 years coming up. We're going to get this done. And, you know, absolutely we have strong support in the Latino community because they've seen what we've been working on. First of all, strengthening the economy. We just were able to get the payroll tax cut done. That provides 25 million Latinos with an extra $40 in every paycheck and is going to help strengthen the economy. We made sure that unemployment insurance got extended because the Latino community has been so hard hit. 1 million Latinos are going to be benefiting from that. The housing settlement that we just passed, which will help Latino families all across the country who were taken advantage of by subprime lenders to be able to stay in their homes. The work we've done on education to make sure that millions of students, many Latino students, are still getting Pell Grants and other scholarships and financial aid so that they can go to college. So there are a lot of issues that we've worked on that have directly benefited millions of Latino families. You're right, though, immigration reform is something that we still have to get done. And as I've told you since before I was elected president, the only way we're going to get this done fully is by getting Congress to do its job. What we've been able to do is administratively, we've said, let's reemphasize our focus when it comes to enforcement on criminals and at the borders, and let's not be focusing our attention on hardworking families who are just trying to make ends meet. We've administratively proposed to reform the 3 in 10 program so that families aren't separated when they're applying to stay here in this country. So we're trying to do a lot to soften the effects of immigration. But ultimately, the only way we're going to do this is to get something passed through Congress, and that's why we have to keep the pressure up. Unfortunately, the Republican side, which used to at least give lip service to immigration reform, now they've gone completely to a different place and have shown themselves unwilling to talk at all about any sensible solutions to this issue, and we're going to have to just keep up the pressure until they act.
Jorge, ¿cuáles fueron los puntos importantes que mencionó el presidente Barack Obama cuando le hice la pregunta de que la reforma migratoria no se ha llevado a cabo en su mandato?